My name is Narasimha Murthy. I am the co-founder and vice president from GeoMega. I lead product management and the development activities. We'll be talking about how we created a Python enterprise product using Python as a business logic. Okay. So far, we as a GeoMega started in 2002. Started using Python as a main primary language. And we started with a small product with having Python as a primary language. And from 2002 to 2006, the small Python application is worked for us and served our business need. From 2007 to 12, we extended the same Python web application, adding a lot of load balancer, memcache, and we are able to serve the mid-size business need from 2002 to 2012. From 2013, we grown too much, and our business need is extended, and the need for us to scale and create enterprise product. So if you look at it, in 2002, 2006, so we started with small. Our web application is Job, and we have a server as controller, view and model, and the controller we used in a Python logic, and the backend as RDBMS, it is connected with any RDBMS. And the front end, we have Apache. This is, started in 2002, it served for us till 2006. It can be, today you can start with small, and without Job, you can also start with Django or Pyramid or Cherry Py. So what it helped us, starting with small. We are able to successfully support 100 to 200 concurrent users. And we use server-side Job template language. And we use server-side GSQLs. And we used heavily on the Python business logic. So we are able to scale 100 to 200 using three mid-size servers. This is what we are able to survive in the business. Between 2002 to 2006. And the business need has grown. We need to serve, we need to extend our product to serve more than 200 concurrent users. So that means, we have a need for 400 to 600 concurrent users. So how do we go about it? So we can't really, start from the fresh, and we need to extend the existing web application. And we also have a need for ETL, which we don't want to buy commercial products. We have written our own ETL product using the same Python language as a core primary language. So if you look at, we are able to use the same Job application and Job server. We have written our own workflow in Python. We have written our own rules engine in Python. It is the rules engine is heavy, and it is required for us to support synchronously, asynchronize events and actions and criteria. The logic is pretty heavy. And we extended the same application using the memcache so that we can serve more requests and more users. And we use the same RDBMS. It can be any RDBMS we will be supporting. And we will be deploying with the customer need for any RDBMS. It can be MS SQL Server, Oracle or MySQL and Postgres. The choice is client for the RDBMS, but we support all the RDBMS. And if you look at, we also added the load balancer in front of the web application, which is written, which is started with Job. And we are able to, we use Pound and Apache, both of them in our deployment as a to serve the 600 concurrent users. And the ETL, it is heavily written, it is more code in Python. Everything is in Python. When it comes to transform, extract, everything is in Python. It is our own logic. And the loader, we used SQL Alchemy. So this is where we added the one more the ORM, which is again Python based. And we also used memcache. So if you look at the stack, we added Apache, Python, same job. We added SQL Alchemy. We added Memcached. But the Python is the core language for us for the workflow and the rules engine. So with the extending the small to the mid-size, we are supported from 400 to 600 by just adding the Memcached and the ETL and the rules engine and using the load balancer. We use the same server-side job template language and GSQL and the same business logic in Python. And we developed our own workflow and the rules engine and the ETL process in Python using the SQL Alchemy. And then we also converted to serve, sustain the business, to support the 600 concurrent users. We also converted the front end technology, which is JavaScript AJAX calls using YI, that time when it is very popular. We added one more server for the ETL process. And this is where we are at. Today, we started creating a large scale Python application for from 2013. We are going to continue to extend this stack and to support minimum 30,000 concurrent users. So that is where we are. We have benchmarked and tested for 3,000 concurrent users with the same model. But again, the core business logic is still remains same, Python, and we use the same logic, rules engine, workflow, everything is same. But if you look at the front end, we added a middle layer, which can be supported as the service bus we added, which is again the open source product, the WSO2 open source product we added. If you look at it, enterprise service bus is WSO2, API manager is WSO2. That helped us to take any input from mobile and the real time interfaces like APIs with JSON, XML, SOAP, and the batch process. We are able to consolidate and convert from all these input XML, CSV, and JSON and everything. We are in the middle layer. We converted one format called JSON. That is the JSON format. We have used RabbitMQ to scale as a synchronized and asynchronous process. We extended the same business logic using the RabbitMQ Python workers that can scale the way we want to scale. So the backend is same, business logic is same, Python workflow, rules engine, and the model if you look at it, the model which we written previous year in the SQL Alchemy, that is where we consolidated as one model to be used for the application and the middle layer also. So again, here the front end, it's we use some part job, some part pyramid, but we plan to replace job in a year or so. And the technology changed, the need for the web browsers and front end technology changed, and if you look at it, the web application front end, we converted from the server side job template language to front end technology in AngularJS, which is HTML templates. So it is heavily dependent on the client side performance. The browser, currently there are so many modern browsers having modern technology to support the client side template language. It is not just AngularJS. There are so many options available in open source community. If you look at the middleware and the web application which is coming from the mobile uses the APIs which is developed and using the same business layer, and it can be extended our business logic to the third party users or external users as APIs. So the change here is if you look at it, is the same Python logic and rules engine workflow, and we converted as a RabbitMQ Python workers, and the front end we changed as an AngularJS, and we used the middle layer that helped us to support any format and extend our business logic to the external vendors also. So what is that we benefited adding all these technology and middle layer. So if you look at the history, you know, if we use the same same business layer developed on Python, it is very heavy, complex logic, you know, written in Python. We can't really, you know, take any challenge or any chance to replace that. We have to continue the same Python logic which we have written from 2002. But, you know, we extended, you know, with you know, Python in the rules engine and the workflow. And, you know, we are able to deploy the same functionality and, you know, use the same, you know, components across the platform. You know, using the same, you know, deployment, you know, which is enterprise deployment, we are able to scale and, you know, and we are able to support the security, you know, having the middle connected to the web application on the middle layer, which is identity server, which is common for that entire platform. You know, we don't have a security enabled, you know, one for the web application, one for the middle layer, which is, you know, API and a service bus. We use one security layer for the entire connectivity, and we also, you know, able to build service-oriented architecture, which is again the middleware. You know, if you have seen, that helped us convert any format to any format. But, you know, when it comes to the business logic, you know, what we have for our core business logic, we converted as one format, you know, internally, that is JSON format, you know, and then we are able to scale using the RabbitMQ. And again, you know, we converted, you know, the latest technologies in a server side instead of server side template language. People are moving into the client side template language, which is again from last 1 year, more than, you know, 1 year, you know, we took to convert the server side template languages to AngularJS. We are able to scale with the current the deployment what we have with minimum. We tested with, you know, 4 servers. We are able to scale and support up to 6,000 users, and we are confident that, you know, we can support, you know, 30,000, you know, concurrent users. But, you know, it is had to be tested, you know, with all the sizing and hardware resource and how we can grow horizontally, vertically. So that's we are able to scale again with the enterprise product, having middle layer, having RabbitMQ, and, you know, having queues. We are able to scale vertically, horizontally without any issues. So what is GMA experience with Python? In simple words, Python, we started using Python in 2002 with a small web application. Today, GMA has grown to use large-scale enterprise application and products. We have grown from 20 Python developers to 300+ Python developers from last 14 years. So we started with small, but, you know, we use Python as a, you know, primary language, and added a lot of Python developers now from last couple of years. So we all know that some of them, you know, why we are using Python, who uses Python. Just to give an idea, why we started using Python. This is where we started, you know, using Python. We know that it is easy to learn, and, you know, you would have seen that on how we maintain the same Python logic from more than 10 years. So it is easy to maintain. And most of us think, you know, Python is just a scripting language. That is not true always. So we can build enterprise products using Python. It is again cross-platform, and, you know, you have seen that, you know, we had experience. We are able to build enterprise product using the same Python logic as a primary language. It has good concurrency support. You know, we all think Python is lacking the concurrency support. We've proven in our product it supports a concurrency by adding. It's all about, you know, how you write your code, how, you know, you optimize your code, how you, you know, deploy and plan your platform using the same Python logic. And it is all about design and, you know, writing the good code. So Wandall is using, you know, Python. If you look at YouTube is again, you know, it is heavily developed in Python. I think, you know, there 90% of the code is in Python. They have more than, you know, 100, you know, maybe 100 plus Python developers working for, you know, YouTube, eBay, PayPal, and Google. If you look at the commercial side, Bank of America, they are using Python as one of their Python as, you know, one of their core technology. They are having almost like more than 5,000, you know, Python developers, you know, working for Bank of America. This is, you know, some of the companies, you know, which I am aware using Python as a core technology. And if you look at today, all the young generation and, you know, a lot of people selecting Python as a challenging language. If you look at, this is from the Code Eval. You know, Code Eval is you know, the challengers portal. If you look at Python is at 31%, you know, as of this year. A lot of people adopting and learning and writing challenging, you know, program, challenging code using Python, you know, from the Code Eval. You know, it is not just from Code Eval. There are other portals which is available, you know, for, you know, writing challenging codes. That, you know, all proven that, you know, Python is one of the popular language which is selected by, used by, you know, a lot of developers. So as overall, you know, if you look at, we are able to use the same Python logic which we started from 2002 and able to use the same Python logic till now and unable to scale. So any questions? The business logic is after middleware. The middleware is not in Python. It is, you know, that the WSO2 product, and if you look at it, that is in Java, the Java-based middleware. We use the middleware to convert the input format like XML and CSV and JSON, you know, any format in which comes, you know, we are able to accept any format and, you know, transform, you know, using that same middleware, you know, which is again Java technology, it is not Python. But, you know, if you transform that into the JSON and able to use the same Python logic which is there on the back end, you know, through the RabbitMQ and, you know, through, you know, JSON format, that's how we are able to scale.
One more question, having that role there, in because Facebook is using Hadoop to track all the customers, their posts, their videos, everything regarding, and Yahoo also.
Yeah, I'm not the, I don't want to take any chance talking about other other companies, but, you know, what I know or what I learned, YouTube is using C Python. Okay, though it might have written C code, you know, legacy, but, you know, they are able to convert that as a C Python and, you know, use the Python as one of their, you know, primary language. And, you know, when it comes to Facebook, yes, you know, they are using, you know, Hadoop, but, you know, they use Python for all the scripting.
No, so, basically, I was guessing how it is being applied in the enterprise level in comparison to Java. I'm not comparing with Java, but how Python finds its place in these distributed and big data applications.
The big data application, we are, you know, we are to do the R&D, but, you know, it is more about writing a lot of Python scripting, you know, with business logic. So you have, you know, data coming, but, you know, you use Hadoop to convert, you know, all that, and, you know, use the Python for you know, a complex business logic, you know, okay, which can, you know, can be converted as, you know, any format,
okay,
for your, you know, visualization or, you know, data analysis.
Thanks a lot.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah, my question is, how do we bring in asynchronous nature of the middleware messaging structure on top of the web application that you described as a synchronous request response system? So,
yeah, if you look at, you know, we are seeing, you know, from the web application, we are able to use synchronized and, you know, asynchronous format. So if anything, you want to have a backend process, I don't know, even, you know, you can have synchronized queue which is waiting for the front end. So we are, you know, direct, you know, we are in the, you know, in junction of transforming, you know, completely into the event queue system, not directly, you know, talking to the business logic through the web app. So that the down layer, you know, what we have, you know, we have want to reduce that down layer talking to the business logic, you know, from directly to the web API. So if you look at it, you know, we are in the process of going through everything, you know, event queue system, which can be, you know, synchronized and asynchronized based on your business need. I don't know the logic, you know, you built.
My question is like, why Apache was used as a choice instead of like there are other web servers like Nginx or UWSGI web server. So why Apache?
It's again, it is our experience, you know, because it is more of a commercial product. It is not just that, you know, we limited to Apache. We used F5, and you know, we used, you know, Pound, and we used. We have not really tried Nginx, but F5, and you know, even, you know, for that matter, you know, we tried for, you know, we deployed in IIS server also. The front end is our choice, is our experience is more with Python, you know, Apache, where we are very comfortable with Apache, you know. That is where, you know, we are able to continue with the same Apache.
Excuse me, which Python interpreters are you using other than C Python?
Other than C Python, you know, just normal Python, you know, we are using. You know,
okay,
we
only
have,
C
we have
Python.
Not used Iron Python or any other things.
Okay, so which are the biggest performance bottlenecks you have faced with the Python stack?
The performance bottlenecks, it's more about if you look at the previous image, right, you know, it is in the sequence, right? You know, we are, you know, that is where, you know, we got into the bottleneck. You know, we are not able to scale, you know, in a sequential mode. So that is where, you know, we said, let's have as a RabbitMQ, as you know, workers, you know, we can spin the workers, you know, as we grow, you know, we can extend the workers. So that is where, you know, we added, but the limitation is, you know, we don't have a middleware in Python, right? So we always have, you know, some of the open source like Mule and, you know, WSO2, which is very popular nowadays. This is again, you know, open source product developed in Java. That is where we don't have, but, you know, we are able to scale without the middleware also. If you just remove the middleware, you know, we are able to scale, you know, using the RabbitMQ, or it can be an ActiveMQ or, you know, any MQ. So we are able to scale. It's more about how you write your code. So it is all about, you know, how do you optimize. We spend a lot of time on, you know, reviewing the code and, you know, fine tuning the code.
Okay, so it is so your workflow is suitable for a queue based architecture.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Hello. So my question is related to the queue-based architecture. So how did you prioritize the queues? Like, if I get a request from FTP, and comparatively if I get a request from mobile, now mobile has to be served much more quicker than any kind of FTP requests. So, and again, like your web application you mentioned using AngularJS. So again, that is has to be like, the returns has to be like much from much faster from the server, the request return.
Yeah.
So how did you manage that?
The way we managed, you know, if you look at the web app, you know, from, you know, which is, you know, heavily used by, you know, all the users, that has, you know, dedicated controller and dedicated queues. So it is only, you know, it will listen to the queues, you know, which is dedicated for web application. And again, you know, if you look at the middleware where we have the API manager and API gateway, that is where, you know, it has the flexibility to configure how you want to use the mobile and, you know, for the real time, what is the priority, what is the business need, you know, what kind of client you have. So if a client, you know, is a small, you know, if we purchased only for 25 requests run to the max, you know, at a given point of time, that is where we are able to control and configure through the API manager and API gateway. That is for the external.
So the queues were managed right in the RabbitMQ itself, the priority
queues? Yeah, right from the middleware. No, yeah.
And where was the infrastructure, like load balancers, all was placed into it? Like, any idea? Like, means seems to be a bit cluttered for me, because Zope parameter is directly calling controller, and then we have the third-party integrations going through events. So where do we see the load balancers placed?
The load balancer remains same, you know, that, you know, because I just, you know, included the load balancer in the previous, you know, images. I am not able to continue the same design here. But the load balancer is again there, you know, between before the Zope open pyramid. So that load balancer remains same. Again, we have the load balancer and the control and configuration in middleware. That is again WSO2 product. So we are using now two products. One is Apache, in the same Apache. We have continued here with the web application, and middleware also we have the load balancer.
Another curious question from the previous slide, like, why would you have a web server Apache before the load balancers? Like, wouldn't the web server Apache have its own request limit?
Because we used Apache as a public domain on a server, right? You know, we are able to the public domain, if you look at, that is the only server accessible outside the world. So everything else is, you know, within the network. You know, it is security wise and, you know, more control. It is not exposed and outside. The only server is exposed to the public is the Apache. But again, you know, we can remove Apache if you look at it. You can start with your load balancer server itself. So it is not really required, you know, to be used, you know, both the servers. You can use either one, or you can continue the same way.
Thank you.
To Python 3, what are your thoughts of Python 3 in general?
That is our next step. We are able to continue. Now we came to this stage, using the same Python 2, but Python 3 is, we need to plan and, migrate to the Python 3 from Mono 2. Now that is the next step, the next milestone we have.
Okay, for a new application, would you use Python 2 or Python 3?
New application, if you look at it, I prefer Python 3 than Python 2. But Python 2, it is, a lot of help and, community, a lot of products is available. But I'm not sure, the same level of support and community and, the third-party packages available in Python 3. That is one of the thing we need to compare and evaluate and maybe start using Python 3 for all the open source community modules. We are using Python 2. Those, modules should be available in Python 3. So that is where we'll be, start using the Python 3. Yeah. And if you look at it, is not just limited to what we designed or what we used. You can replace. You can think about how you can start the small web application or any application with Django or Pyramid, Cherry PY, any of these, open source products. And, you can replace, if you look at having the Python as the core language and core, business logic, you can replace, anything from the middleware to the front end. If you look at the web application, with an AngularJS, you can also replace with, any front end open source products like, apart from AngularJS, there are other template languages. Even Yahoo also has some. They are available. So you can think on how you can develop an enterprise product. This is just to give you an idea. Python also can scale. We can also use Python into the enterprise product. It is all about how we optimize and plan the sizing and deployment process. Okay. Thank you very much. My colleague Baiju will be giving a talk about how the web deployment and web application can be used. He'll be continuing with his presentation. Thank you very much.